Raw's resident pariah. Now it's a EST of the WWE, Bianca Belair and Tamina.
Bianca Belair has her sights focused on this Sunday in Brooklyn as a member of the Raw team for the women's traditional Survivor Series elimination matchup. We still have an opportunity to finish out Team SmackDown, one slot remaining on their side of things.
I'm still curious about whether or not Team Raw can actually get along.
I'm still wondering why Aaliyah was removed without any real reason.
There's a lot of questions surrounding members of certain teams on certain brands.
Right now, the EST bringing the fight to Tamina. No fear being shown by Bianca Belair.
Interesting, this match is happening right now for Bianca Belair. Usually, she has the strength advantage, the athleticism advantage, but Tamina just as powerful. Very dangerous for Bianca Belair right now.
Talking physical strength, Tamina may be the only one who can match power with Bianca Belair, but Belair right now just oozing confidence, feeling herself, and bringing the fight to Tamina.
You have to appreciate this attitude from Bianca Belair. You got to believe, taking all that frustration that she would love to take out.
Oh!
And Tamina nearly took Bianca's head clean off. A massive clothesline. And this is the aggression that helped take Tamina to the WWE Women's Tag Team Championships. Ain't nobody meaner than Tamina.
And what would it mean for her and her singles career to get a win over Bianca Belair? That would be absolutely huge.
Who knows? The way things have been going around here on Raw and SmackDown recently, if Tamina picks up a win here tonight, she might replace Bianca. And there's Doudrop, who wants to replace Bianca already.
A big smile on the face of Doudrop, who's obviously enjoying the fact that Tamina is controlling Bianca Belair right now.
Doudrop enjoying herself, playing with her hair, watching with glee as Tamina begins to dismantle the EST. Deep rear chin lock applied, wearing down Bianca.
When we've talked about momentum in 2021, you have to talk about Bianca Belair, but that breeds envy. It breeds jealousy. It puts a target on your back. It looks like everybody's taking a shot right now.
And listen,
goodness. Speaking of shots,
Bianca has tasted defeat recently, which is something she's been relatively unfamiliar with, particularly in 2021. This is a woman that won the SmackDown Women's Championship in the main event of WrestleMania. But right now, Bianca looks fallible.
Beautiful elbow by Tamina. Shoulders down to the cover.
I don't think it's a stretch to say that Tamina might be one of those superstars who also believes Bianca's got too many opportunities. Boom! In case of point, taking her angst out on Belair.
I agree with you, Saxton. Tamina in full control right now. Bianca needs to make something happen.
Remember, Bianca Belair so close to defeating Becky Lynch for the Raw Women's title. Just slipped out of her grasp.
And listen, I'm going to say it. Maybe Doudrop had a point. Maybe Bianca has exhausted her options. Maybe Bianca has crashed and burned, so to speak.
You got to understand the flip side, Corey. You look at the resume. Listen, we talked about it. Bianca Belair is a former women's champion. Doudrop has been on Raw for a cup of coffee. Does she really deserve that opportunity to represent Raw?
Doudrop certainly seems to think so. We see the athleticism of the EST. Spinebuster into the cover.
To the cover. Not quite three.
Nearly enough to put Tamina away.
Look at somebody you said might be past your prime, might have crashed and burned. I see someone who
still
has athleticism. Look at
past
that.
Past their prime, Jimmy. The EST's still approaching her prime. Just ask Tamina. But Tamina not ready to call it a night just yet.
I see a very dangerous Bianca Belair in there. And because of those losses that you mentioned, Corey, maybe a little bit more to prove.
Big palm strike and a super kick. Down goes Belair. This could be Tamina's moment. Tamina realizes it, looking to make the climb to the top rope, could be looking for the splash that has brought her so much success.
If Tamina hits this, it will be over.
Bianca Belair to her feet just in time. Trying to elbow Tamina off her perch. Look at that!
There's the aforementioned power of Bianca Belair.
Who on the WWE roster can pull off that kind of a move on Tamina?
Tamina got the knees up just in time.
Completely stunting the momentum of the EST. Tamina. Remember, Tamina is a former tag team champion with Natalya, one of the most experienced superstars we have here in the women's division.
And Bianca finished the job. Not yet. Tamina still with too much left in her tank.
We knew this was going to be a fight. certainly lived up to it. Tamina looking for that Samoan drop. Countered by Belair.
A straight right rocks Tamina. No way.
Look at KOD.
Unbelievable.
There it is.
He hit it.
To the cover. One, two, three. A win for Bianca Belair.
Here is your winner, Bianca Belair.
As we have learned, she herself has taught us on numerous occasions, you can never bet against the EST of WWE. A hard-fought, well-earned victory.
Oh my gosh.
I still can't believe it. We just witnessed it with our own eyes. How in God's name was Bianca Belair able to muscle up Tamina, deliver the KOD, pick up a big victory, and continue the momentum as we head toward Brooklyn and Survivor Series?
And you can't underscore enough the value of
Doudrop for entertainment value. Come on, Saxon, you were dancing a few weeks ago.
I'm not condoning the latest actions of Doudrop, Corey.
Doudrop simply asking the questions that is in the mind of many.
Now that you've had a match, you must be exhausted. It wouldn't be very fair of me to come down there and take advantage. But I just want to let you know, after Survivor Series this Sunday, I'll be looking for you.
Believe me, the EST will be looking for Doudrop as well.
Well, one thing, the roster this stack, we had a fatal five-way match. See who would take on Becky Lynch. I don't think it was the winner anyone expected.